Welcome back everyone. In the last episode, we discussed why it is important to exercise freedom of movement and choice with your little ones. The freedom in a Montessori environment is actually termed freedom within limits. Now, freedom and limits are two contradictory terms. Let me explain to you their correlation with a simple example. Earlier, when Arman and I would come to the park to play, I literally had to follow him everywhere he went in the fear of him running to the parking lot. Now we have reached a stage where I can sit in one corner of the park and have some me time while he runs around the area enjoying his freedom without being stopped by me. It took some time for him to get to know his limits in the park. But once he had known them, he was as free as a flying bird, rarely interrupted by me during his play. This is my understanding of freedom within limits. You let them know their limits so that they can be free of any external interference when they are having a good time. So today we look at how limits can be applied in a positive manner without causing frustration to the child and you. In a Montessori system, the term ground rules is used to describe the rules that everybody in the environment, including the adults, has to follow to bring about peace and harmony. These rules help the children to feel relaxed and in control of themselves, since they know what is expected of them and what has to be done in a particular situation. And always remember, there is no point getting a child to obey you with fear or love. They'll not follow the rules when you are away. What you're aiming for is a self-acquired discipline which can only be attained when you free their bodies and souls in an environment where the limits are clearly set. This is one of the most beautiful concepts of the Montessori system to me. So now, let's look at some ways you can set limits for your child at home. At home, have a set of rules that you practice as a family. Young children might not have developed the ability to grasp and follow a rule easily. Make sure you repeat it consistently in a gentle manner and that you keep modeling it to your kids. For instance, your child might not be ready to clean up their toys at a young age. Keep reminding them that we clean up after every activity and model it to them. Make it interesting and get them involved every time until they pick up and start doing it themselves. If you give up, they give up too. Always stick to the rules and don't fall for tantrums. For example, at our home we have a rule that we only eat at the table. When my son was a young toddler, he would often ask me if he could eat on the couch. It was very tempting for me to let it happen one or two times because I knew the problem would be settled for the moment and he would eat well if I let him sit there. But if I had let that happen then, he would take it as a rule that could be broken with a little bit of crying and pleading, and sooner or later he would make it a habit. So I let him cry for a little while, making sure I was next to him to comfort him, and before I knew it, he was eating at the table. For things that have to be done anyway, like personal hygiene, do it without much negotiation, regardless your toddler likes it or not. My son was very hesitant to brush in the morning when he was a young toddler. We kept telling him he had to brush his teeth in order to keep them from forming cavities. We'd keep the bathroom door shut till he finished brushing and would stay inside with him. His dad would brush with him. Initially, he would cry and try his best to escape, but we did not give in. Soon, he realized there was no way out and he had to do it no matter what. We never used harsh words on him to get him to do it. Instead, tried more and more to make him understand the importance of brushing teeth through stories and stuff. What I'm trying to say is, do not give in for tantrums thinking it is just one time. Stick to the rules and your child will soon realize there is no escaping from it and it is a part of everyday routine. When it comes to safety, there is no excuse at all. You can be physically involved when stopping them from harmful actions. For example, if your child is trying to touch boiling water, remove him or her physically and tell them it is hot. Physical action will give them a clear instruction here. But make sure you're not overwhelmed when you do this. Speak to them gently, still in a firm tone, making yourself very clear. If you want your child to not break a rule, make sure you're not breaking it in the first place. Remember, they are constantly absorbing things around them. In the earlier mentioned instance, if your child sees you eating on the couch, he'll not take the rule seriously and will use it against you the next time you ask him to eat on the table. Have a routine for your child. They crave for it. It helps them know what to expect next and what they are supposed to do throughout their day. You could be reminding them of the things that are going to happen on a particular day so that they can set themselves up. But make sure you keep a balance. We shouldn't be overscheduling a child's day. This is against the most important principle of the Montessori system, which is following the child. Making routine cards with pictures can help your child visually follow it throughout the day. Giving options works almost all the time when it comes to getting your child to obey or do something. When Arman would refuse to brush when he was smaller, I would ask him questions like, "Which song would you like Mama to sing when you brush, this one or the other one? Who's gonna squeeze the paste out, you or Mama?" Make sure you're not asking a yes or no question like, "Are you going to brush or not?" When he's too lazy to clean up his animal figurines, I say, "Where do you want to start from, the tiger or the elephant?" You're giving them an opportunity to take their own decision and be listened while making sure that you're getting them to follow the rules. Avoid saying no constantly and reserve your no's for very serious matters. It could be very frustrating for a child to be hearing this on a daily basis. The things that they do are not something that they have control on. They are following their natural instincts. It is developmentally very appropriate for them. No toddler can be labeled naughty. If you keep constantly using the word no, it tends to lose its value over time and soon your child will pay no heed to it. Find positive ways of saying things and redirect them as much as you can. Like instead of saying, "Don't draw on the wall," you can say, "Let's find a paper or a board to draw because that's where we draw, right?" Instead of saying, "Don't jump on the bed," you can say, "Bed is for resting. You can jump on the floor." Just when I was editing this video, Arman started hitting the mirror with a hardcover book. I told him he could use the book to read instead of hitting the mirror. If the child continues to show unacceptable behavior even after redirecting, you can physically remove them from what they were doing without being harsh on them. Getting your child to follow a rule doesn't have to be a hard experience to him or her. Enforce the rules with love. Maintain a calm and balanced tone. Let them know that you love them even when they are at their worst. Hug them, connect to them physically and emotionally. Instead of asking your child to clean up their mess, tell them, "Come, let's do it together." Don't make them hate such chores. Sing a song and bring in some fun. You can try redirecting and giving other options. If they still throw a tantrum, be there for them. Address and acknowledge their feelings and emotions and hug them if they let you. And take care not to go overly emotional or use sentiments. When your child refuses to come back from the park and starts crying but you have no other option than take them home, you can tell them, "You might be feeling sad, but we can always come back again and play here. Right now, we have to go home because we have to take a shower, eat, and then go to sleep." That brings me to the next point. When you ask your child not to do something, make sure you're giving clear reasons as to why. Your child deserves to know it. Instead of telling them, "Stop hitting your brother," tell them, "I have to hold you back from hitting your brother because that's hurting him." These are just a few tips that you can use to enforce ground rules in your house. Initially, they might fight and resist when you set the limits. Remember, whatever they do is developmentally appropriate for them, even if it is hitting their friends or siblings. They are testing boundaries. You can keep modeling and redirecting them gently and firmly until they get hold of it and internalize the rules. Dealing with temper tantrums positively is a whole topic in itself, which we'll talk about in another video. I hope you all found this video helpful. In the next episode, we'll look at how to set up the environment to allow freedom of movement, choice, and repetition to your child and to bring about maximum independence. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up and share it with your friends and family. And if you're new here, do subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.